And I just want to show a film clip from the end of your film where you talk about forgiveness, right? Because it's such a major theme. And this film clip from the film, I think it's pretty faithful to the way that your books, your first book ended. Right? So can you show this film clip? Basically, the film clip says, you returned to Vietnam, you had a sort of a tense reunion with your family, but in the end, you really emphasized this message that forgiveness is possible for everybody. That means you forgive your family, they forgive you, and you also forgive American soldiers. It's a very important theme of your book that you begin and end with this idea that no one is utterly responsible for the war, but instead everyone is a victim of the war. Was it hard for you to get to that point of being able to forgive, given everything that you said, everything that you saw in terms of the war and what you talked about in the book?
When I left my village, 1964, I was 14 years old. They called for me to forgive Americans, all South Vietnamese, because how much I was my father and my village. But in 1970, I moved from Vietnam to the U.S. And I see all the wife, all the mother, the father. I understand how they struggle, because the children didn't leave his father. And they get right in front of him. How can you condemn them? How can you not feel sorry for them? They're like, I feel sorry for my father left me, or I left him. All this misfeeling. Little by little, I love them more than they did. I don't have hatred. The forgiveness came when I really understand about Buddhism. 1975, when the American Jew came, I helped establish the first Vietnamese Buddhist temple called Bakhan. Now it is 17, but before it in my neighborhood, in Denmark. So I start to volunteer there every day and practice understanding about forgiveness and what forgiveness will do out there. And it's not very far from what we believe in the village. You lived in a village for 100 years, just like my parents. They set foot down in a village in 1925. So now the house is still there. They still drink the water the same well. The water laundry is the same water still. They're eating the same food that they harvest from the land. So you cannot do something that people condemn you for. You have to face every day what the thing that you've done. So you cannot hold people again so long. You have to forgive and let it go. But first, forgiveness is for yourself. Oh, I have a lot of guilt. My two husbands died on me. My father died on me. My brother Sal died on me. I left my mother. I mean, I have a lot of guilt. I have a lot of time to do. But they're all dead. They're all gone. I'm here. And if I'm not forgive myself to move on and function on and do good things, I will be able to run forward. The Vietnamese father is much different than the American father. The Vietnamese father, he showed the love, he is working very hard in the rice paddy. He showed his heart, he showed his love to the children that he's worship the ancestor every day and make sure that the children have food on the table. And so, because I'm the youngest and all my brothers and sisters left home, so I become the faithless daughter of his. And the relationship between my father and I get very special. We had a water bottle with our past, and that is also our income provider. So I take here good water bottle because it's my path. And to him, as if I'm a good daughter, to take a good care of my path. And same with the cat and the dog, and go down to the pond to get big fish for him and get the snail and crab and all that to bring home for the family dinners and help to cook in the rice paddy side by side with him. Because no sons, no daughter before me, still at home. So then I become one of his, not only daughter, but also work together in the fields beside my mom. And the hardest thing for me even today was when I left home at 14 years old. And in the book, and you can see how sad he was and how much he misses me and all that. And I tried to find my way back, and I couldn't. And afterward, he told me that every time, because he, you know, our house is up in the hill, and so he keep looking far, far away, where every day I walk home, all the bamboo lined up. Every time he see a water buffalo, he aimed it at I am on top of the water buffalo. And he waited and waited until it just vanished. And he knows that just a ring. That never left me. The relationship of father and mother in Vietnamese culture is very important. To hear, I'll be honest, you take for granted. But for us, because of the war, because of the hardship, because of the poorness, and we have nothing except each other. The love is not like, oh, I'll take you to Disneyland tomorrow, I'll take you to baseball game next weekend, or we can go to the beach. It's not like that. Everything that yeah, here to feed for you, I eat the bone, you eat the meat. I eat the hot pot of the rice, so you can have soft part of the rice. The love from the parent to the daughter and to hope the daughter will become a good wife someday to somebody and marry someone in that village so she can come home. If she can be a good daughter, she can bring some food and write to the family. Those kind of things, what is hard to find here? Here is very individual, very selfish, and it's not a different kind of bond.
Ma'am, when you were in America and you heard people saying Vietnamese people are the root of all these problems, did you ever start to believe that yourself a little bit, or were you always resistant to that idea?
I believe it a little bit because my education did not. My language is not there to confirm of what or how I want to respond. Therefore, it's my loss. However, I am complete as a human being. I have my own thought, I have my own heart, and have my own belief, whatever it may be. Of course, 10 people have different 10 ideas, 10 questions, 10 answers. I had one just for me, what is good for me. To be a wife, to be a mother, to be a good US citizen, to be an honest human being, and work very hard to earn a living. That's what I believe.
The question was, can you talk about the American, your reaction to 1975 when Vietnam, the war in yeah. Vietnam ends? And comparing the American and Vietnamese reactions? Okay.
My sister, Lon, who now lives in San Diego, she had two children, Amaris and half American and half Vietnamese. I had two children also, one is half American and half Vietnamese. So in 1975, she sent me a telegram and said to me, you have to bring me to the U.S. because my children is half American and communist come and kill them. Therefore, I sell everything I can to get $10,000 in 1975. That is a lot of money. I give it to my boyfriend in those days, Dennis Hayslip, who we dated, not married yet, and went to promise him that if he could get my sister out from Vietnam to here, I will marry him. Okay, so life is just a deal, okay? So he took $10,000 to Vietnam, married my sister, and find her way out, and he get out of there on March 28th, 2 days before the sidewalk fell. He stuck in warm for 5 days before he arrived in Cape Canaveral. So in those 5 days, I heard nothing from him. So I thought he dead. He stuck in Vietnam. And that all I could do was cry, oh my God. So when he and my sister came, the sadness to see all the chaos going on, but again, I'm happy the war is end. My husband, Dennis Hayslip, who is not Vietnam veteran, but career, fought in Korea. He is very Southern Baptist religion, the anti-communist. My question to him is, why do you hate Vietnamese so much? He said, I don't hate Vietnamese, I hate communists. Communist. What is communist? Why is communist such a big deal? My brother went to North Vietnam in 1954 when I was 4 years old, and he's 16. He became communist, I don't know. My brother Bun, Sao Bun, followed the Viet Cong in 1962. I was 12 years old. I helped support the Viet Cong. I dug the tunnel, I gave them signal, I did everything for Viet Cong against the American war. But I don't understand the communist concept. I just do. So when my husband, so much against communists, and most of his American had the same feeling, say, oh, now Vietnamese refugee come over here, take our job, be on the welfare. What are we gonna do? They should stay where they belong. We should kill all the communists in Vietnam and come home. Still, I don't understand communists. I just understand the Vietnamese fought for Uncle Ho against the invader. So, from that reaction, I start to just zip up my mouth. My children said they're Mexican and not Vietnamese. I had no voice, no face, not even a name to say I am Vietnamese and I can speak it for myself. So about why the book come out, with that mind, it really bothered me. It really gave me something to go on. When people give you a false, not true story because they don't know about you or they don't know any better, you don't just fight with them. You fight with yourself and find the way out. Find the path that you can express yourself.